हेलो चिल्ड्रंस, लेसन नंबर 5 दैट इज ऑपरेशन ऑन रैशनल नंबर्स. ऑपरेशन ऑन रैशनल नंबर. दिस लेसन आई एम स्टार्टिंग बिकॉज आई थिंक आवर ऑल द लेसन्स रिविजन आई टुक इन बाय यूजिंग द ओपन बुक टेस्ट एंड इट डिस्कशन. सो आई होप यू डोंट हैव एनी डाउट विद दिस. इफ यू हैव डाउट यू जस्ट आस्क मी. And we will start the lesson number 5th, that is the operation on rational numbers. So you know that first of all, just previous inside we will see which are the natural previous knowledge. Let's recall inside we will see, check our previous knowledge. Okay, so first of all tell me which are the natural numbers. Okay, I hope all of you know that the numbers which are 1, 2, 3 means greater than 1, all positive numbers. 1 and greater than 1, all positive numbers are natural numbers. Okay, these things you have to fit in your mind because it is very important. This is the base of maths. And if you know the base is perfect, there will be no difficulties for you in the studying maths. Next, it is the whole numbers. So tell me which are the whole numbers. I hope scholarship students and last year also I think I taught you this. Which are the whole numbers? The whole numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3 and all numbers remaining all. So the natural number inside if we are adding the 0, the numbers are called as a whole numbers. Okay. Then next is the integers. Which are this? That is the integers. So integers means the 0, all positive numbers and all negative numbers together it is called as an integers. Okay, these things are clear. From this what we are understanding that all natural numbers are whole number. Okay, all natural numbers are whole number. All whole natural numbers are integers also. Means natural numbers are whole numbers also and integers also. Then whole numbers, all whole numbers are integer. All whole numbers are integer. But all whole numbers are not a natural number because 0 is not included in the natural number. 0 is not included in the natural number. Next point is the integers. I told you all natural numbers are integer, all whole numbers are integer, but we can't say that all integers are natural number or whole number because if we think about the natural number, positive numbers only are the natural numbers, but in integer negative number and the zero is also there. So this statement is wrong and whole numbers also same. This is the basic natural number, whole number and the integers. Now the next question is the rational number. The spelling is the R-A-T-I-O-N-A-L, rational numbers. So you will think that which numbers are called as a rational numbers. So first of all, let me clear you that all natural numbers are rational numbers. All whole numbers are rational number. All integers are also rational numbers. But the one thing is that the but means what is but inside it? The numbers which are in the form of P and Q. Question. The rational numbers, according to the definition of rational numbers, the numbers which are in the form of P upon Q or A upon B, you can take in your textbook what taken, I don't know, but generally P upon Q taken. It may be A upon B taken. I will take it here, P upon Q. So numbers which are in the form of P upon Q, P and Q are integers. Means P may be positive, Q may be positive, it may be negative, it may be zero. No problem. With this, no problem. But here that but is there. Condition is that Q is not equals to zero. The meaning of it is that the denominator of the fraction must not be zero. If numerator is zero, no problem. It is a rational number. So from this, some of the examples I will tell you, it will bear better for you for the understanding rational numbers. So rational numbers means which I told you P upon Q form in this side in this and P and Q are integers. okay, p and q are integer, but condition is that q is not equals to 0. So suppose I will take example of 2. Example of 2. Tell me 2 is a rational number. Yes. Yes. Why? P upon Q form, we can match it with this. So 2, you will say that teacher, only 2 is there, Q is not here. Means denominator is not there. But you know that if single number is I've gave you, the denominator always 1 is there with it. So 2 is a rational number. Minus 3 is also a rational number. 0. Yes, it is a rational number. Minus 5 upon 3. Yes, is it a rational number? Yes, it is. It fits inside the P upon Q. P means minus 3, it is integer. And Q is 3, it is integer. So, all the numbers are integer. So, 7 upon 9 you take, 100, 155 upon minus 3, 7 upon 3. All numbers are the rational number. 0, yes. 5, yes. Minus 9, yes. It is a rational number. But, condition is that denominator must not be 0. Suppose, instead of writing 2 upon 1, I will write here 2 upon 0. According to formula, P is an integer, but Q is a, what you get? Q must not be equals to 0, and that's why the 2 upon minus 0 is not a rational number. Clear? From this, what do you understand? Natural numbers are integers. Whole numbers, natural numbers are, here it is the format given. Just now I told you that this is called as a Venn diagram. This is called as a Venn diagram. So you will notice that here all natural numbers means all the numbers. Just now I taught you, same method is there. So natural numbers are, which are the natural numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on and so on and so on. In these natural numbers inside, if we are adding the 0, this is called as a whole numbers. Means 0 plus all natural numbers are called as a whole number. This thing you just fit in your mind, then it will be not difficult for you for doing the mathematical operations. Next is the integers. From this you will notice that natural numbers box, whole numbers box are inside the box of integers. So from this we can say that, the natural numbers, then whole numbers means, natural numbers means all positive numbers, whole numbers means all 0 plus all positive numbers are included in the integers inside this green box. Okay, so integers which are there, all the positive numbers, 0 and negative terms are called together called as an integer. And if you will see here, you will notice that this natural number, whole number and integers together, it forms the, all are included in the rational numbers. Okay, inside it, how you will, just if you take the exam, our school standard, such a type of example I will tell you, it will be better to understand you them. Instead of natural numbers here, if I will write, here I will write first standard. Okay, four standards has two divisions. Suppose this is the A division of first standard, this is the B division of his B division. Okay, no, we can't take it like that. So here first standard students are there. These are first standard students, and inside this some students knows the swimming, those will come inside this. So these are both are included in the first standard, and this included in the Sevagiri English Medium School. Sevagiri English Medium School is included in the Paris Education Society. Okay, in this way what happens, we can say that the terms are natural number, whole number, integer and all are rational numbers. Paris Education Society, Sevagiri also there, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th standards are also there, and your class is also included inside it. Okay, understood all of you this? Next step is the natural numbers, integers and rational numbers. So we have to tick here. You know that minus 3, negative numbers are natural numbers? No. Negative numbers are integer? Yes. Rational numbers are integers? Yes. Negative numbers are there? Negative numbers. Minus 3 is rational number? Yes. It fits inside that P upon Q, and Q is not equals to 0, and P and Q are the minus integers. So rational numbers are, so rational numbers are integers. Now the next is the 3/5. According to the natural numbers, what I told you, if you see here, which numbers are there included in the natural numbers? All the positive numbers. 3/2 is a whole number, it is there, complete numbers are there. So 3/5 is not a natural number. Why? Because it is a fraction form of the number. If you divide this, you will get the decimal fraction. Next, integers. Next is the integers. So first of all, minus 3/5 is integer? No. Is integer? No. According to the definition of integer, all positive, all negative and zero numbers are, zero is included in integer, but fractions do not. Now tell me, is it a rational number? Yes, it is a rational number. Why it is a rational number? It fits in the formula of a rational number, that is P/Q form, and Q is not equal to, means denominator is not positive. So it is a rational number, right? Next, it is the -17. First of all, tell, negative numbers are natural number? No, they are not a rational numbers. Negative numbers are integer? Yes, negative numbers are integers. And negative numbers are rational number? Yes. Okay. So next is with the -5/11. Fractions are not natural number. Fractions are not integers. Fractions are rational number. Denominator 11 is here, 0 not. So it fits in the formula of rational number and it is a rational number. Next it is the 5. 5 is a positive number. That's why it is a natural number. 5 is a positive and it is fits inside the integers term, so it is integer also and it is rational number also. From this, what we say, that all numbers are rational number. All numbers are rational numbers. Okay. And from this, I hope you understand the what are rational numbers. And in this lesson inside, we are going to see operations on natural number. What? Operation on rational numbers means on these rational numbers, which are in the form of P/Q, okay, P/Q, we have to means which is Q is not equal to zero, such a type of numbers are there, on it operation. So mathematical operation, which are the mathematical operation? Addition, subtraction, multiplication and the division. These are the mathematical operations. That operation study on rational number we will see in today's in this lesson. So let us take first example. 5/7 and 9/11. 5/7 plus 9/11. Okay. So here some of the example we will take from this and then we will stop this. So here, if such a type of example will come, you have to find out the LCM of this denominator. Or sometime LCM, if I will say, you think that it is a very big or huge or heavy word, it is there, but it is actually not. 7 and 11 table inside, which is the first common number, if you see here, 7 times are 70. You said that, teacher, 7 and 11 table, nothing is common. Nothing is common, but 7 and 11 are the prime numbers. If prime numbers are there, then 7 table inside 11th place, 77 is there, and 11th place table inside 7 place 77. So this is the first common number in the 7 and 11th table. So we have to convert this denominator of a fraction into 77, because LCM, or the first common number of this denominator, is the 77. So 5/7 into 7 table inside 11 is at which place? 11th place. That's why I multiplied the fraction 5/7 with the 11 for the two numerator and denominator also. So 9/11 into 7, because 11 into 7 is equal to 77. Okay. Now 11 5s are 55. 11 7s are 77. Next, 9 7s are 63. 11 7s are 77. Now if you see here, the denominators are same. If denominators are same, you just add the whatever is there, addition or the subtraction, which sign is there, just put it there. So here 55 plus 63/77, and then you will get it here, 118 means 118/77. In this way, we have to do this is the additions operation on the rational number. This is the, these two are the rational numbers, right? And here addition, how to do, we understand it. Okay, so here it is given 118 upon 77. One subtraction example we will see, and this example third we will see tomorrow. So 1 upon 7 minus 3 upon 4. 1 upon 7 minus 3 upon 4. Here also 7 and 4 LCM means one prime number is there and one prime and one even number is there. So 1 upon 7 minus 3 upon 4. So here 4 and 7 table inside, first common number is 28. So 7 4s are 28. So 7 into 4 and 7 into 4 because 7 4s are 28. And then here 3 upon 4 into 7 into 7. So 4 1s are 4, 7 4s are 28. Plus 3 7s are 21, 4 7s are 28. Okay. Then this is the LCM. Okay, 28. And now the denominators are same. So here 4 plus 21 upon 28. And its answer is 25 upon 28. Clear? In this way, we have to solve the examples or do the operation of addition and subtraction on the rational numbers. The next examples we will see in our next lecture. And today we are going to stop here only. Okay, thank you and have a good day.